Hi guys, hope all of you are doing well. Today I want to talk about mealybugs and the hibiscus plant. Now I have a wide variety of hibiscus plants and I have a mealybug attack in one of my balconies, so I decided to make this video because a lot of my friends think this is a fungus because they see it white colored cottony substance on their plant, and then there are people on groups asking what this is and how to get rid of it on their hibiscus plant, and it's a very very common problem. So I decided to make this video today to help a few of my friends out. Now this is the mealybug. Can you see it? Now it's white in color. This is a dead bug. It's changed color because I just sprayed it with neem oil. But if it's alive and doing well, it will be very visible and it will be white in color. Now see how it is sticking to the underside of the leaves. Okay, so this bug is a very common infestation in hibiscus plants and will be visible near new growths. So you don't have to search your entire plant for it. Only see the stem tips. So this tip here, see, can you see this tiny bug here? And it's moving because it's not gotten any spray. See? So this is what I do to get rid of mealybugs. This is a 1 liter spray bottle. I mix half a teaspoon of neem oil and half a teaspoon of hand wash. Any hand wash will do. This has Dettol hand wash in it. And all I do is spray the areas where I can see the bug. I do not spray the entire plant. Now, if you spray the entire plant, what happens is your leaves will start turning yellow. Because hibiscuses are very temperamental plants. And even the slightest problem in them, they will make it very apparent that, there is something that they dislike. So do not spray your entire plant with this oil and just pick the spot. See here, can you see? Yeah, so I'm just going to spray this spot right here. See, let's turn this to the other side so you can see. So all I'm going to do is spray that spot. Now, I spray until all the whiteness goes away. So that way I know that the entire bug collection is dead. See? That's it. Do not overdo your oil and your hand wash, because if you do that, your plant will be in extreme distress, more distress than the bugs are causing it. Okay, and ensure that it is only half a teaspoon of neem oil and half a teaspoon of hand wash in 1 liter of water. Let's talk about the hibiscus plant now. Now this is a very very vocal plant, and by vocal I mean that if it has any sort of problems, it will let you know by turning its leaves yellow. So now my plant had a mealybug attack, and here is the yellow leaf to prove it. You overwater it a little, it will prove by turning its leaves yellow. You do anything to it, underwater it, it will turn its leaves yellow. See here, even this plant has a little bit of a mealybug problem. This balcony, I have about 6-7 hibiscuses, and most of them have slight mealybug issues. So I've been checking them for bugs today. We do it almost every day and solve the problem as soon as it hits. See, this one has it here and this one's escaped spray as well. So I'm going to spray this one a little bit. So if you treat your mealybug problems at this stage, it is easier obviously. See how it is embedded itself inside that leaf there, right? So any new growth that is happening, you should spray that new growth immediately, and this bug will suck all the sap out of your plant. So your plant is not going to grow, it is not going to flower, it is not going to do anything except turn all of its leaves yellow. So ensure that you tackle the mealybug problem as soon as possible. Now, I have potted this hibiscus plant in a mixture of red soil and gobar khad. I use only organic fertilizers because chemical fertilizers will not just make the gardener sick when you're handling it, but also poison your soil, and you will have to keep changing your soil every 6 months because of soil deposits. That is one. If you have planted your plants in the ground, it is going to contaminate the groundwater. And I am just not for chemical fertilizers. There are so many organic fertilizers available, and I think we should make the most of it. See how mealybugs are attacking my flower. So these mostly will attack your flowers and new growth. Okay, that's where you need to check. See how my leaves are turning yellow because of mealybugs attack. Okay, but you don't have to worry so much about the yellow leaves. Your plants will survive it. It is no big deal. But just ensure that the mealybug attack doesn't get really, really bad. Okay, you need to spray this continuously for 2 to 3 days. That means all of the infestation will, addressed. Now, because you are human, you can only do so much, and you can only, observe so much. There are chances that you will leave some of the colonies out. Right? See here. Can you see that? So, when you do it multiple times in a few days, that way all the bugs will get hit. And okay, this plant has a little more than I expected it to. See? See? Yeah. So, if you do it 2 to 3 times in a week, you will be able to address the entire issue. Keep monitoring your plant very, very closely. Do not get this get out of hand. So I fertilized this last week with gobar khad. I put in a handful of gobar khad in every pot. I planted all of my hibiscuses in a 12-inch pot, and I put in a handful of gobar khad, and I fertilized them last week, and you can see ample amount of buds in every plant. See, in a week's time. Now I'll fertilize these again once all of these buds bloom, and it's time to give them more food so they can make new buds. See how I'm only spraying the tips, I'm not spraying the entire plant. Because the plant goes into extreme distress if you spray the entire plant with oil. Okay, just the spots where you can see the bugs. That's all. See how every plant of mine has multiple buds? That's because of gobar khad. Okay, you don't have to worry about the flower. The neem oil doesn't destroy the flowers, only the bugs. But if you overdo it, the entire plant is going to turn yellow. So don't overdo it. Okay guys, that's it for me today. And if I've left anything out, I am going to put text scrollers in my video to give you more information. Thank you for watching, and thank you for your time. Bye. Okay guys, so one thing I did leave out was propagation. So I thought I'd just add a few words on that. This is my hybrid small pink hibiscus, which I'm going to use to show you how to make your cuttings. Now, propagation of hibiscus plants can be done in multiple ways. You can use seeds, so you can hand pollinate your flowers and let them seed and then store the seeds. But the easiest way is through cuttings. So now, incidentally, I had a pot full of cuttings that I planted about 2 weeks back. So I thought I might as well show you. So what I've done is, all of these are different varieties of hibiscus that I got from friends. And I've potted them in the same pot to let them root. Right? There's no point in potting them in separate pots to let them root, and then some of them die, and your garden basically doesn't look that great.
So what I do is I let them root in the same pot, and then whichever succeeds, I transplant it into their own pots. So now this pot, it's been two weeks completely, I think. Yeah. So some of the twigs have shed all its leaves and dried out, and some still have green leaves. And this is a little surprising for me, because hibiscus will shed all of its leaves before it's roots and starts throwing out new leaves. So now, if your hibiscus stalk has shed all of its leaves, all you have to do to check if your plant is still alive is to scratch like this. Okay, so if it is still green underneath, okay,
you see the green. So if it is still green underneath, that means it's alive and it is going to send out new shoots.
Okay, so don't take it out and throw it away just because it has gone bald. It is rooting, it is doing its job, and it will throw out a new leaf someday. So just have patience. See, all I do is I scratch it. I don't have nails today, so the scratching is a little difficult. See how it is green inside? Can you see that? See? So this also is still alive. Now these still have green leaves, so you don't have to be in any doubt that they're alive. Okay, they're very, very alive, and they will throw out new... Oh, there you go. There are new shoots already coming. See? So this plant is actually ready to be potted into a new... into its own pot. But I'm going to still wait for a while. Okay, but looks like we have a success here. 2 weeks, so that's not bad. This one is also alive, and it is also throwing in new shoots. See, can you see that leaf? So success here as well. Now this is also showing new shoots. See, there you go. So another successful cutting. Now these two, they haven't shown any new growth yet, but they're still alive, so we are going to wait on them. Okay, so that's that. Now let's take a look at how to take hibiscus cuttings. Now you can't just cut any branch of a hibiscus plant and then expect it to root. It will not. So if you cut this plant here and then expect it to root, it will not root. What you have to do is, this main stem here, you see this main stem, right? You have to take a branch that is coming off of the main stem. Okay, so if you take this, you have to take it from here. If you take this, you have to take it from here. Okay, you can use this here, all of these cuttings can be used. You can grow this, even this tiny branch will grow into a new plant. Okay, just cut it here and grow it. But any cutting that you take should have a few cells of the main stem. If you just, let's say, take a cutting here, even though there are nodes here, this will not root. Okay, and even this particular branch here, okay, if you take cutting here, it will root. If you take cutting here, it will not root. Okay, so that's the secret to rooting a hibiscus plant. You have to take the nodes that are attached to the main stem. Okay, so now I think that covers everything, and I hope this video helps you take care of your hibiscus plants better. Please excuse all the mess in this particular balcony. I'm in the process of cleaning my balcony and redecorating, and so some of the pots are not in the best of condition. So yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching, and see you in my next video. Bye bye.